Today, we're going to explore some key ideas that you want to implement when you're building your synchronous sessions. Synchronous sessions are extremely powerful. We want to build a session that is going to invite people and build that community. It's all about the engagement. That's where we're going today. So, sync sessions, synchronous, that means real time. The focus is community. The focus is exchange. The focus is discussion, engagement, right? Am I missing anything on the focus, Alyssa? What are your thoughts?
Nah, I think collaboration and building in opportunities for kids to be interactive with you in that sync session is one way you can really get them connected and not fall asleep during your sync session.
Connection. So make it engaging. Now you mentioned kids. But what if you're teaching young adults? What if you're teaching high school students, or you know, you're in college or something? It doesn't really matter the age level. We all want to engage. We all want to be heard. We all want to have our voice responded to. And these synchronous sessions are a time where people can connect. And one of the challenges we face with online learning or blended learning is that we don't have that opportunity to necessarily build that relationship in a face-to-face setting. And so we need to do that relationship building online. And these synchronous sessions are that time where we can build those relationships. They are that time when we can actually get to know people. We can explore. We can laugh. You know, we can sympathize. You know, we can be who we need to be. And it's a real live session that allows people to come together, to let everybody know who they are, and to communicate and to establish that rapport that is so, so important. Other thoughts on the sync sessions?
Yeah, I'm thinking, let's say I'm a classroom teacher, I have 16 kids face-to-face, and I have four of them that are attending online. You can easily interact between both groups. There's so many digital tools built right within Zoom or any other video hosting platforms that they can raise their hand, they can pick up the mic, and they turn those mics on, and maybe they don't have their video cam on, maybe they do. I would encourage them to use the tools that are available to them, no matter what device they're on, and just call them out. Hey, Dwayne, you know, we were talking about this. What are your thoughts on that? And you can engage them by asking them questions, addressing, you know, certain things that are important to them. And they can be just like they're in the classroom with you. They're just attending a different way. How cool that we've gone to this kind of teaching and learning format, you know, with all the digital tools that we have available to us. This is a really unique opportunity, I think, for our teachers.
I think you've addressed a couple of key things that I want to key on, and that is the tools right within tools like Zoom. You have the ability to use a breakout room. You have the ability to use a poll. You have the ability to chat. There's a lot of things that you can do that are engaging. So in the sync sessions that we encourage people to do in our professional learning environment, they're 10 to 12, maybe 15 minutes at most. And the focus is engagement. The focus is collaboration. The focus is getting your participants talking right away. Within the first 2-3 minutes, they're in a breakout room. Breakout rooms, really 3 or 4 people maximum. You really want to have them small so people can engage. And then when you bring people back, they're able to talk, they're able to explore, they're able to share their experiences. And even in a short breakout, a short sync session, you could have a couple of quick breakout opportunities. You can do a variety of different things. So the focus is not delivering information. The focus is the engagement, is the collaboration, is experiencing the ideas and thoughts and discussion of others. And so in the synchronous session we ask people to build, we're asking them to build that collaboration, to build that opportunity to communicate, to help them build that community of learning. That's the focus, not content delivery.